My name is Yen Zhang, and I'll be your presenter today. And I'll be presenting on connecting ASEAN countries based on the change in aquaculture. So it's perhaps a fact now that our climate is changing, and that's why probably this idea contest is being held. So climate is changing, and it is changing the fish's habitat. And now the change in fish habitat is affecting humans socially and economically. So what we try to do is first identify the problem statement and then propose our thesis and then explore data, explain what we discover and propose what we can act on it. So first, problem statement. So I explain how climate change disrupts aquaculture and aquaculture changes the habitat of marine species and that causes socioeconomic harm for people, so for many countries, to be exact. And when we talk about that, we usually focus on how to prevent or fix the climate change. So for example, we try to bring awareness to people by not using hairspray or useless CO2 or having a global pact such as the Paris Agreement. However, we would like to shift our gear to adaptation. So it's a fact that global climate is changing and that we know that it will not going to come back in any time soon. So we have to adapt whether we like or not. So we want to suggest that we should adapt into the climate change and turn the crisis into an opportunity. And how to do that? We suggest that by creating a visualization of the changed habitats of marine species, we would like to uncover the achievable connections among countries. So we're suggesting that there are connections already created, but we just want to discover that connections. So the data we use is from Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, or in short, it's called FAO, and the data's name is FishStatJ. And we also use another monograph, and we kind of modify the data to focus on the network. So it means that rather than focusing on value itself, we focused on the change of the value. So if whether it's increase or decrease is more important to us than the data itself. So we try to identify data into four different sections, into increase, decrease, dangerous, and new. And you can read the description for yourself. And we try to use that data into visualization, and we divide a visualization section into three. So first one is a production per year. So with this data, you can project the change in production of a marine species based on a year and a country. And I will promote this in later part of the presentation. And second and third one is a network flow. And first of the network flow is the financial network. So this is an example of a financial network, and it shows the import and export of the network that can be created. And the second one is a technical network. So it shows farming technology or food recipe and other cultural references that can be created with the fish movements. And this is an example. So first example with the groupers, we specifically picked this because this is an important food fish and mostly farm, and also this species is affected by a climate change. And with this example, we would like to show that with this example, it has a market already created, and we can show that with the actual example. So this is our website that are created, and you can select the fish in here, groupers 9, which is an example, and select the country. So right now it's a whole, but we include all the ASEAN countries and Republic of Korea. We visualizes it, and we were surprised to find out that right here you see that Brunei is a small dot, but when we activate the animation, you see how it burst out in a big pink circle. It means that, as you see here, this is a stack plot. You see how Brunei kind of pops here and becomes like a big circle. So this can be shown, and this can be discovered with this visualization. And if we click here, it shows the country name, amount, and status. And it also changes based on the year. So you can play with that. And also you can see the cultural exchange, financial exchange with this. So this thickness is shown, this means that there are more network that can be created. So thicker the line is, there can be more relationship between those countries. So like this, countries have thicker relationship than with South Korea. And now I'd like to move on to the second example, which is white leg shrimp. And this is also because it is a familiar species around this ASEAN regions, and this is easily farmed. So this can show the promotion of technical farming, exchange and technical relationship. So let's move on to white leg shrimp. And if you do that, it will reroute. And if we click this, you can see that there are green regions and light blue regions. So light blue region is like a new. So new means that it appears new after 2005, and we thought 2005 is recent enough. So the other countries have been farming or catching this species, so they can contribute a cultural network to South Korea. So this network is showing that, and you can also play around with it. So I explained in basic idea what can you do with the data, with the visualization that we created. And we would like suggest two actions. So first action is related to what we faced the problem. So first problem that we were kind of faced was that there are a lot of data, a lot of local data and global data, but they don't have unified unified standard, so to say. So we thought it'd be very important to have a unified data set. And by doing so, you can help prospective scholars or any other people like us who want to research, and it will promote more discoveries. And second action is that we can draw a line in a map based on the graph, but we cannot actually create this connection between countries. This is up to the other countries and industry. So we thought if the government or the industry can actually look at our data set and visualization and understand what's going on and try to actually build on the data set and actually build on the connection, then there will be more to be produced. So I would like to end with this circle. So we started with the new data and then circled around once with the actionable. And now it's up to you that to decide whether you'd like to really act on it or not. And if you act on it, you will create a new data and will find a new problem, and you will follow this circle. And then new action will create new data and then another circle. So hopefully by the end of five or six circles, then climate change will be over and everyone will be happy again. And this is our website URL. So if you guys are interested, please go into igo700chinyapps.io/chinyapps /flow/. And thank you so much for listening, and thank you so much for UN for contributing action toward climate change. Thank you.